So let's head over to the computer. It's really simple. This is going to be a short one, but it's going to really help you. So here we are, and I've turned continuous playlist off. So you'll notice that if I go into a song, everything's good until I get to the end, and I still have stuff over here, but it's like it gets stuck. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what is continuous playlist, and why should you use it? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever been in a situation where your ProPresenter doesn't seem to list more than one song at a time or whatever, or it does go from one to the other and you don't like that, go ahead and tell me about it in the comments below. Also, while you're at it, like this video, subscribe, and share this with a friend that might find it useful. So, continuous playlist is a feature within ProPresenter that I always leave on. Always. And so much so that I forgot you could turn it off. Well, I didn't forget. It just didn't occur to me that anyone wouldn't have it on. Well, I was teaching a class recently in person, and as a result, someone said, hey, mine doesn't look like that. It's only showing one song at a time. How do I fix that? Like, oh, yeah, that's continuous playlist. So let's head over to the computer. It's really simple. This is going to be a short one, but it's going to really help you. So here we are, and I've turned continuous playlist off. So you'll notice that if I go into a song, everything's good until I get to the end, and I still have stuff over here, but it's like it gets stuck. So if I go there, then I hit the space bar, right arrow key, whatever, it will go to the next thing, and then only show that it'll select it with the first thing and then actually show it with the second. So go through this entire one. Now to go to Egypt, I press the space bar or right arrow key once, and then hit it again, and that does it. So it can work, but like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person. Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got a either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem. You can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. It's more difficult. So here's what you want to do if you're in that situation where you get to the end and there's more stuff here, but it's acting like there isn't. So here, let me show you the opening of the tutorial. Notice we got all this space here that's just wasted. So not helpful at all. Maybe your announcement presentation is like that, something like that. So let's do this. So first you go to view up here and then go down to continuous playlist and watch what happens when I click on it. Right there, it selects nothing. But if I were to go ahead and go back in here, now these are connected one to the other. So that's exactly what's happening. Now it does the exact same thing. So if I hit the space bar here and it then selects the next item in the playlist, and then it actually plays it when I hit the space bar again. So the behavior is the same. It's just how it looks on the interface. Personally, I prefer this, but it could be that it's more intuitive to you that you need to hit the space bar twice if there isn't something immediately down there. I wish there was a way to turn that piece of the puzzle off, because I would like it to just go seamlessly from one presentation to the next, but it doesn't do that. No big deal. Just keep in mind that that's what it is. So that is continuous playlist, the difference between having it on and having it off, and why you may or may not want to do that in ProPresenter 7 and newer. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.